CGM!
What is going on, everybody? It is your boy, your homie G, CGM here. It is 8 o'clock in the morning, and today I am going to be bringing it to you all, the Myrtle Beach Vlogs Day 1.
Whoa. This is pretty old. Let's try something new.
What is going on, everybody? It is your boy, your homie G, CGM here.
What's going on, guys? It is your boy, the Dante Program here.
And it is now time for the moment you've all been waiting for, the CGM TDP podcast Myrtle Beach special.
Oh, yeah, guys. It's going to be a great one.
All right. So we're going to start off here now. We did a few things down here in Myrtle Beach. You know, one of these nights, I actually whooped TDP in a game of air hockey. It was pretty bad. 7-0.
It was total bull.
Right. Whoa, I'm going to have to put the whale noises in there. 7-0, Dante. 7-0. And then 7-3 in the second game.
Yeah, at least I didn't get sweep that time. But the puck would always bounce off of my, what are they called again?
The handle things
that you play with. It always bounce off and go in my own goal.
I don't know.
Every time, almost he scored.
Excuses, Dante. I don't know. So I don't know if you guys heard about this. I might put a little story edit in there somewhere. But Bernie Sanders told us no balls in the pool.
Thank you.
Now, as part of my presidential campaign, I order that Margate Towers shall never have balls in the pool ever again.
Thank you.
He's the one that has no balls, really.
Oh, okay, Dante. All right. And we saw the return of Alex Trebek. I'm going to put that on the screen for you right now.
Here is the host of Jeopardy, Alex Trebek.
All righty, guys. I hope you enjoyed Alex Trebek. Now, we also went to the Quickie Mart from The Simpsons. It was really sick. There's going to be some video appearing right now. It was just a really, really cool, you know, replica of the actual Quickie Mart from The Simpsons show. Now I never actually watched The Simpsons.
Not me neither.
No. So, I mean, I still thought it was cool, even though I never watched the show, but, you know.
I've seen a few things, like, not really episodes. I've just seen it a bit, seen it online, but I've never watched anything.
Yeah. I always wanted to watch the movie, but I haven't watched it at all. I might have to watch it at some point.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to get straight into our first segment here of the TDP CGM Myrtle Beach podcast special, whatever you want to call it. So we're going to talk about Star Wars Celebration.
Oh, yeah, guys. Great. Amazing. I was hyped.
TDP, he's got the Star Wars hat on, Star Wars shirt. See? You already know. Man, all right. I'm going to be putting my reaction to the, The Fallen Order trailer. I did already see episode 9. I haven't seen the Fallen Order trailer yet. I'll put that in this somewhere. And we're going to talk about episode 9 right now.
Oh, yes.
So,
let's get comfortable.
I'm sure you guys, if you haven't watched the trailer already, go watch it, because we're going to spoil the trailer for you right now if you haven't seen it. So, Palpatine.
I know that
Palpatine.
He knows how my reaction was, because I was listening with headphones. He couldn't hear it, but why don't you tell him what you saw?
Okay, so basically what happened was we were in Broadway at the beach, and we were in this retro arcade store. I don't know what it was. It's a wicked cool store. So Dante and the kid that carries the channel, he's over there. We're watching the trailer with their earbuds in. All of a sudden, I see Dante's face go like this, like, oh my God. I'm like, what just happened? And he goes, Palpatine! I'm like, wait, no way.
Yeah.
So I watched the trailer for myself, and I was like,
a surprise, to be sure, but a welcome one.
No way, this is actually legit. Palpatine is going to be in
chills,
episode
guys.
9.
Chills, guys. Absolute chills throughout my whole body when the laugh came through. I was like,
yeah, it was just so nuts. So what do you think this means for, like, Rey's parents? Do you think it has any correlation to it, or what do you think is going on there?
There's a possibility, since obviously it was very much hinted, and I'm pretty sure it's canon, that Palpatine was Anakin's father, so a lot of people may think that Palpatine may be Rey's father, or maybe like her creator in general. Obviously, we'll have to wait and see what the movie does, but there could be a connection as well between her and Palpatine. So
exactly, and you know, the whole title, The Rise of Skywalker, yeah. I mean, that also brings up the point of, like, what if Rey was actually
a Skywalker,
right? Like, that would be insane. I think that everybody would really love that. You know, J.J. Abrams, I feel like he is going to save this Star Wars franchise. You know, The Last Jedi was really, really, in my opinion, it was disappointing. I thought it was, like, there were some scenes that I thought were cool. Like, I don't know if I necessarily enjoyed Snoke's death, but I thought that the scene with Kylo and Rey just destroying everybody was sick. That was a really cool scene.
You like the hyperspace scene where they ram the ship?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it wasn't that. Yeah.
The cinematic on that was amazing. Good. I like that.
The beginning, Poe. Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah. Poe's such a... He's amazing.
And then, I'm trying to think. What was the other... Oh, yeah. And then Luke's death was very important. Yeah, that was I'm half and half on Luke's death. I think it was somewhat good, somewhat bad.
There was a lot of good aspects to it. The double sons showing through all his stages in life, basically. If you watch the movies, the music as well, it just adds up and it's amazing.
And then I remembered Rose is in the movie too. So we're gonna move on from that discussion and we're gonna get straight into the Fallen Order. So I haven't seen the trailer, like I said. I'm gonna put my reaction in right now.
The next day.
Alrighty, guys, it is now the next day. So I am going to be now reacting to this Star Wars Fallen Order trailer. So let's get straight into this.
Okay, we open up here. Alright, so I'm guessing that this is the guy.
It's always like this.
Oh, Respawn Entertainment? That's interesting. That's the same people that made, like, Apex and Titanfall and all that.
There are three rules to survive.
He kind of sounds like Makarov from MW3, I'm not gonna lie.
Stand out. Except the past.
Let the past die, kill if you have to. Oh,
trust.
We got some stormtroopers. Dun dun dun.
No one.
Okay, so, like, these graphics are, like, okay. They're not amazing, but they're okay. Like, but that looks kind of good. So, I don't know, we'll have to see. Oh, shoot, this guy's dead. He's tall! One of those movie cliches.
Don't reach within.
Some Avengers music.
Don't stand out.
Oh, what is that? Oh, so they're doing the wall running thing like they had in Titanfall 2,
except
I guess?
The past. Execute Order 66.
Oh, that's sick. Execute Order 66. Okay, the combat looks kind of sweet, actually. That's gonna be really cool to use the Force. I'm so used to using the Force in the Lego games, you know, back in the day. Okay, so I'm guessing that's one of the main enemies.
Trust only in the Force.
I don't know if I like this guy's voice, to be honest. Alright, there it is. Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order. We're gonna get something out, become a Jedi November 15th, 2019. That's coming up right before the movie. All right. So, my thoughts on the trailer, it was all right. I mean, it was okay. I saw a lot of aspects from like the Titanfall games in there, and I guess it's gonna be a breed of like the Force Unleashed games from back in the day, and a little mix of Titanfall. So it looks kind of good. I mean, I'm looking forward to it. So we're going to get straight back into your regularly scheduled program.
All right, TDP, so what is your thoughts on the Fallen Order trailer?
So the trailer, I liked, it was pretty good. I liked the music. I liked the theme, how it's kind of like a dark, like, you know, everyone's dead. All the Jedi are gone. I'm like one of the last survivors, you know. You need to kind of accept the past that everything's gone, and you have to keep moving on towards the future and maybe try to take down this empire.
All right, so I'm going to watch it. Like, just the fact that, like, it takes place after Order 66 and this Padawan survives and stuff. Yeah. It just seems like they could do a really cool story. Like, EA, no microtransactions.
I mean, pure single player, anyway, so.
Right? Pure single player, no microtransactions. Yeah, I know, Gio, if you're watching, I knew that he was a huge, huge like fan of this, and you know, I'm looking forward to the game myself. The trailer, I already watched it. You saw it. Everything will be good.
Really interesting to see like who his master was. How did he survive Order 66? Because obviously we all know the clones, they killed all the Jedi. Anakin did as well. So was he in the temple? Was he like on another mission with his master? Are we ever going to learn this? It'd be cool to see if there's a little beginning scene in the show, you know?
Right. Okay, so let's move on to The Mandalorian.
Oh, yeah.
So The Mandalorian, what are your thoughts on The Mandalorian?
I mean, right now it looks like an amazing show. Obviously, they didn't show a lot, but from people recording inside the room, we get to see some footage, and it looks pretty good. I like the theme of, like, you know, there's just this one guy, a lone gunslinger, kind of doing what he needs to do to survive. So, and then plus the remnant of the Empire kind of fitting in there as well, bringing some stuff back from other eras. It's going to be pretty cool, I think.
Yeah, like, I don't know about you, but I was a huge Rocky fan. Or I am still a huge Rocky fan.
Carl Weathers is in it.
Carl Weathers.
He's going to be.
Carl Weathers. And I heard that they're going to have a huge directing cast as well for this.
Oh, yeah. I saw there's a lot of characters in it.
Yeah, it should be fire. So what else happened to Star Wars Celebration? We had Episode 9. We had The Mandalorian, The Fallen Order.
Oh, we had Clone Wars.
And Clone Wars.
Yeah.
So I know I'm going to get some hate from Star Wars fans. I didn't watch The Clone Wars. Dante did. Season 7, I heard, is going to have Ahsoka versus Maul. And
yeah.
It's going to...
It was in the trailer. It's pretty good.
Yeah. So what are your thoughts on the Star Wars Season 7 of Clone Wars?
First of all, they redesigned it, which I really like because it really fits into the designs they have now. And like I said, like you said, actually, Maul and Ahsoka, that's going to be something really cool. The Siege of Mandalore, we heard it was really intense, and it's going to be really intense when Order 66 happens, because we were told that Order 66 happens at the same time, so we're going to have to see what that means for Ahsoka and all the rest of the clones that were there, so...
Yeah, that's going to be interesting to watch. I mean, if I enjoy Season 7, I'll, like I said, I'm going to get hate for not watching the other ones before Season 7. But if I do enjoy Season 7, you know, then I guess I'll go watch the other ones. You know, I'll do what you guys
Maul.
Ask.
He's amazing. You know, he's really dark as well. He basically slaughtered an entire village just so Obi-Wan could get to him. He was like...
I mean, that's insane. Yeah. That sounds wicked dope. I watched the first episode of Clone Wars with Yoda and the clones.
Yeah, that's a good one. I like that one. Cause
yeah, I really enjoyed that one.
Well, Yoda wisdom in that one, so...
Yeah.
It's a good one.
So, I'm looking forward to all these new Star Wars things. I know you said you want to go to California for next year's
Celebration. I was thinking Celebration California would be perfect. Anaheim, and then Galaxy's Edge is right in Anaheim as well. But then, you know, the parents would be like, oh, too much money.
Yeah, you're going to have to convince Mark on that one. Anyway, so now we're going to get straight into our second segment of the show. And let's talk about Avengers End Game and the state of the MCU. So... We saw the trailers for Endgame. Part of the journey is the end. It's making it all sound like this is it.
The final battle, the biggest one. Like, now or never, we do this or we die.
Exactly, basically. You know. Thanos got exactly what he wanted. He destroyed half the universe.
I can't snap.
Yeah, it's just crazy, you know. Yeah, just like that. So I got a couple questions that I, like, you know, thought about in my head, some theories or whatever. If you guys want to leave some theories, let me know down in the comments below. I'll gladly reply to you. We can have a discussion down there. But could Phase 4 actually be a prequel or take place in a different universe from the current MCU?
I mean, there's always a possibility that it could be prequel. It could be ahead of it, and or it could, like you said, take place in another dimension. I feel like they may kind of do a bit of maybe all three. Maybe they'll do after, maybe they'll do a bit of other dimension, and maybe they'll do a bit of prequel. Obviously, it's Marvel. What's his name? The Bob Iger.
Okay, yeah.
Rob Iger, whatever his name is. He said that he has like a 5-year plan, just like Stalin did.
Just like Stalin.
Just like Stalin did.
Oh, no.
He said he has a 5-year plan for the Marvel Cinematic Universe. And he didn't say any of the Fantastic Four or any of the Fox stuff would be in it, but he said that there'd be, you know, continuous Marvel stuff as we've seen. So I think it could really be anything.
I just heard today that from the Fox characters, the only one that's going to stay is Ryan Reynolds as Deadpool. I heard, like, the X-Men are changing.
That's a really good one.
And, you know.
They should really change the X-Men.
Yeah, they should. Okay, so could the characters actually be dead somehow? I know we have the trailer from Spider-Man Far From Home.
And it shows him alive.
And it shows him alive.
And it's after, we know.
And so. I know we're getting Black Panther 2
yeah.
coming soon, probably in 2020 probably. Sometime.
Because I don't think they have any other movies after Homecoming. So
right.
Or not Homecoming, Far From Home, sorry.
So I'm just trying to think, how could these characters like actually be dead? Like, I don't know if there's a way like they could possibly like, be dead.
There's all the theories and stuff lines up to being like, oh, you know, they're kind of in the Soul Stone, or like they're just kind of, they're not dead, but they're like gone for now.
Right, exactly.
Yeah, there was a, I don't know if it's a spoiler, they released a clip, they basically like, of the movie, didn't spoil anything. But it was basically Captain Marvel saying, like, oh, let's just get the gauntlet and bring them all back. So maybe there's a way that they can bring them back using the gauntlet. So maybe one of the stones could do something.
I mean, Infinity War, they almost got the gauntlet.
Yeah, they almost did. And then, you know, Peter Quill is just like...
Yeah, yep. Bah, done.
Yeah, he's like, you live...
Yeah.
You killed my girlfriend.
Exactly, right? There was, I don't know. There was so much passion in Infinity War. Yeah, it's going to be so tough to beat.
It is.
It's like, going to be so tough.
There's going to be, obviously, we think Endgame, you know, a lot of people think that a lot of characters are going to die. Like, this is going to be one where characters actually die, not Infinity War dust, but die. So, that's going to be
right.
a tough
like,
one as
I
well.
I feel like Gamora's actually dead.
Yeah, like...
She is not coming back.
We see her fall to her death.
Like, exactly. You know. And Loki, unfortunately, Loki's...
Yeah, you know,
I love
he
Loki,
strangled him to death.
Yeah,
so.
he's definitely
that, that's like two characters, you know, they have to be dead. I mean, if they bring him back some way, you know, time... Stone, reality, whatever they could use, but I think they're dead for now.
I don't know. This is going to be so tough to call.
Yeah. Next week, so.
Yeah, yes.
Like,
coming this Thursday.
I can't believe it's literally next Thursday that we're going to be able to watch it.
It's
going to
be insane.
So.
Maybe we do a review or something
maybe.
For it. Possibly. We'll see what's going on. But, so the Russos, you know, they said that no one has predicted the ending of this film. So, how could this film possibly end?
Like, I mean...
It could end in so many different ways.
And obviously no one knows. So.
Right, exactly. Like, I saw in the Far From Home trailer, you know, the check. There was a check in there signed by Pepper Potts.
Yeah.
So why wouldn't Tony have signed
so
the check?
So it's like, ooh,
is Tony dead?
Like,
right.
You know, that was a big question when that trailer came out. So,
like, I know, yeah, I know I'm not, like, me personally, I'm not a huge fan of Captain Marvel. So, if I see her absolutely destroy Thanos, I'm going to be kind of triggered, right?
I mean, it was crazy. Watching Captain Marvel, watching her fly through ships and stuff. I mean, I think we might have seen it before, but it was still pretty crazy seeing, like, the power she had. So, but I think she won't be able to absolutely destroy Thanos because the movie would be shorter, I'd say.
Right. So, they're going to have to save Iron Man
yeah.
from space. Somehow
they're gonna get him back. Maybe Captain Marvel, you know.
But I that's not a bad like theory at all. I think that'd be a good theory.
Yeah.
And you know, people are debating who's gonna die.
I know, like, you know, is it gonna be Captain America? Is it
gonna
be
Captain
Stark?
America?
Is it gonna be
Iron Man?
Is it gonna be everyone?
Is it gonna be everyone? Like, I don't know. It just Thanos is just way too OP.
Yeah.
Way too OP with that gauntlet. I don't know what is possibly gonna happen.
Great idea for the ending. Everyone's gonna die. There's gonna be one person left. Maybe it's gonna be Thanos left, and he's just like, oh, what did I do?
Right.
Like,
he's
actually gonna get sense slapped into him, and he's gonna maybe use Time Stone, bring everyone back. You know, who knows? That's just a wild guess I threw out there.
Right. And, like, you watched the newest trailer where they showed all of the different,
like
MCU movies.
Yeah.
It wasn't in exactly the right order, but it was in a good order.
It was, like, you know, showing everyone's character off.
Right.
Here.
And I just showed a little bit of from each movie and stuff. I loved that
trailer. That was a pretty good trailer, like, awesome showing trailer. Everyone. So, that was a good one.
So, all right. It's time to get on to our third segment of the show. TDP, you have a trailer. What is this trailer?
This trailer, it's for a brand new dating site. That,
oh my god.
It's coming out very soon.
TDP's
guys.
Dating website. TDP is available.
I'm single.
He wants some
chicks.
He's ready
to mingle.
He's ready to mingle.
Call
so,
me.
Yeah, we're going to show you the trailer for his dating site right now.
My Snapchat's TDP.
Wow, man, oh man. TDP. David Hasselhoff, you had to be just like David Hasselhoff running down the beach. Oh my God.
I mean, I would take my shirt off, but it'd blind everyone. It's just so great.
The sand angel sand. And then, oh God. Oh my God. What else? Oh yeah, the food. Drink in the spot.
You know, we first recorded that. Maybe you could put on the Redone clip. You know, we'll see. We saw the sign. We're like, oh, this is a great idea. So I was like, oh, I gotta get out. He was like, why? I was like, because I am a snack.
I should probably get out because I am a snack. All
right.
And then we had the walrus thing, you know, like the walrus noises flopping out of the pool. Yeah. That is from year one.
I know.
Year
that's one. Pretty great.
Now, I don't know. I want to make a Myrtle Beach parody song. You guys know I love me some parody songs.
A lot of his songs are great. You know, check them out.
I got a whole album out. If you want the deets, let me know. I will hit you up with the Too Crispy album. And now it is time for the final segment, which is, what do you guys think? Okay, we want to hear from you in the comments section down below. Do you want to see another podcast? What are your thoughts on Endgame and the MCU? And what is your ideas, I guess, for episode 9 with the return of Palpatine?
I don't know. There's so many things, but I don't want to speculate too much. Don't want to ruin my ideas, but...
Yeah. Okay, guys. So that is going to be pretty much it with this Myrtle Beach podcast special, whatever you want to call it. I hope you guys did enjoy the video. If you did, please be sure to like and subscribe. It's always appreciated. And I'll catch you all in the next one.
See you guys.
What's the kind of value, please? You know what I mean.